Hello all. Welcome to the new session of Deadlock. In the last session, we have discussed about the process, its states, and process life cycle. In this new session, we will try to discuss and understand the deadlock problem. Deadlock is the phenomena which comes with multiprocessing operating system. That means a deadlock may arise whenever we are working in an operating system with multiple processes. A process in operating system uses different resources in various ways. A process may either request a resource, a process may use the resource, or a process may release the resource. Deadlock is a situation where a set of processes are blocked because each process is holding a resource and waiting for another resource acquired by some other process. Now, look at this diagram. In this diagram, there are two ellipses, which depicts two processes, process 1 and process 2. And there are two rectangles as well, which depicts resource 1 and resource 2. Now you can see that an arrow is pointing towards process 1 starting from resource 1, and it is denoted by resource 1 assigned to process 1. In the same way, we can see that an arrow is pointing towards process 2 originating from resource 2. That means resource 2 is being assigned to or allocated to process 2. Whereas the process 2 is pointing towards resource 1. That means the origination of the pointer is from process 2. It means it is requesting for resource 1 or waiting for resource 1, which is actually allocated to, assigned to, or being held by the process 1. In the same way, the other process 1 is pointing an arrow towards resource 2, which is actually waiting for, looking for, or demanding for the resource 2, which is being allotted to or assigned to or held by the process 2. Now, moving further, that why deadlock occurs, there are certain possible conditions which are required for deadlock to be occurred. It may also be considered as the characterization of deadlock problem. Deadlock can arise if following four conditions hold simultaneously. These conditions are the necessary conditions for the deadlock to be occurred. These conditions are famously known as Kaufman conditions. These conditions are mutual exclusion, hold and wait, no preemption, and lastly, circular wait. Now, moving further, we'll try to understand that what is the meaning of mutual exclusion. The word exclusion means the only one. That means the thing which is not shared by anyone, which is unique in itself. Now, look at the diagram. Here, process 1 allocated resource 1. That means resource 1 is exclusively allocated to process 1. In other words, we may say that resource 1 is not shared by any other process. There should be a resource that can only be held by one process at a time. And this phenomena, or rather, this is the necessary condition for deadlock to be occurred. Moving further, the second condition, which is very important, is hold and wait. A process can hold multiple resources at a time and still request more resources from other processes which are holding by the other processes. The diagram on the screen clearly depicts hold and wait condition. Now there are two processes, process 1 and process 2. In this diagram we can see that process 1 is allocated resource 1. Process 2 is allocated two resources, resource 2 and resource 3. And process 2 is actually looking for resource 1, which is exclusively allocated to process 1. That means process 2 is waiting and process 1 is holding. This condition is known as hold and wait. Further moving, the other important condition for the deadlock is no preemption. A resource cannot be preempted from a process by force. A process can only release a resource voluntarily. That means whenever a resource is allocated to certain process and other process is looking for that resource, it cannot take it forcefully. Whenever the process which is holding or allocated the resource will finish it up, will free the resource, and then resource will be allocated to the demanding process. In the following diagram, we may say that there are two processes, process 1 and process 2, where process 1 is allocated with resource 1 and process 2 is allocated with resource 2. Here process 2 is requesting for resource 1. That means process 2 can only request for resource 1. It cannot take the resource 1 from process 1 forcefully. This condition is known as no preemption. Preemption means pre-empty. Pre-empty means the things you cannot do it forcefully or voluntarily. This is very important condition for deadlock to be occurred. Moving on to the last condition, which is known as circular wait. A process is waiting for the resource held by the second process, which is waiting for the resource held by the third process, and so on, till the last process is waiting for a resource held by the first process. This form is known as circular chain or circular wait. Following diagram explain it very beautifully. There are two processes, process 1 and process 2. Here process 1 is allocated with resource 2 and process 2 is allocated with resource 1. And we can also see that process 1 is requesting for resource 1, whereas process 2 is requesting for resource 2. That means neither process 1 can finish the work nor process 2 can finish the work, or neither process 1 can finish itself or exit by itself, nor process 2 can finish its work and exit by itself, because both are in waiting condition, both are in requesting mode. This phenomena is known as circular wait. It is a very important phenomena, very important condition for deadlock. When all these four conditions comes simultaneously, deadlock occurs. I hope this session will be very fruitful for you. Thank you so much.